And today we are going to make the Noodle Doodle Bot. Can we say that?
Noodle Doodle Bot.
Now this is a fun project that even if you're little like Juliet, you'll still be able to do it. But even my older kids have enjoyed doing it too. Okay, so in your kit you have the pool noodle, the rubber bands, the stickers, the battery, the toothbrush, 3 markers, and the pipe cleaner. Okay, on top of everything that you have in your kit, you'll also need a pair of scissors so we can cut the pipe cleaner. And at the very end, you'll need, of course, some paper so that the Noodle Doodle Bot can draw on your paper. Once you have all that, we're ready to get started.
Yep.
Okay, Julia, the first thing we need to do is pop the end off of our toothbrush. Just pull it off. Okay, try and turn on your brush. Yours works. Okay, very good. Now I want to show you a trick because some people, guess what? Some people, their toothbrush isn't going to work. Do you remember when we made this guy and our toothbrush wasn't working and we were like, what's going on?
Do you see that spring that's down inside your toothbrush? Can you look inside of there?
Yeah.
That spring is a connector for your battery. So the flat part of your battery, not the side with the little bump right here, but the flat side, that's called the negative side. Can you say that?
The negative side.
So the negative side is going to go into your toothbrush. That's the flat side into your toothbrush. Good. And now do you see that your toothbrush has little arrows on it? There's a little arrow right there, and there's a little arrow on the base of the toothbrush. And you make sure when you're putting the base back on that those arrows line up. And that's gonna make our connection go. Are your arrows lined up?
Yep.
Let's check. Oh, nope, the arrow is not lined up with this arrow. So we're gonna turn it right like that. Okay, I'm gonna show you this connection inside of here. There's a metal piece right in here, underneath where your arrow is. There's a metal piece down inside the toothbrush. You're gonna use your fingernail and pull that metal piece out into the middle of the toothbrush just a little bit. Okay? Then you might have to bend this metal piece in a little bit more towards the middle of your toothbrush because those two pieces have to connect in there. Again, they're right by your arrow, so if those two pieces connect, then your battery will work for sure. So once those pieces are pulled in just a little bit more into the middle of your toothbrush, you're gonna again put that negative side into the middle of the toothbrush, match up the arrows, and test it. Is it working? Okay, I wanna show you what's happening inside of your toothbrush. Inside of here is a vibrating motor. Vibrating means when it goes up and down and wiggles and gives you that tickle brush feeling. Okay? So vibrating motor looks like this. Or something similar. It has this piece on here that spins around when it's attached to the battery. And see how right there? That puts it off balance. And when you're off balance, when you don't have your balance, what happens? You're moving around like this. So that's what your toothbrush is doing. And that's what makes it all wiggly. Okay, so now we're gonna take our toothbrush and we're gonna insert it into the hole of our pool noodle. Okay, and you're gonna push the pool noodle onto your toothbrush. Oh, you are so strong. Good job. Okay, now test it again. Yep, mine's working. Is yours working? Okay, if yours isn't working, this is a great time to take it out. Ugh. You might have to have someone help you get it out because that is really hard. If the base gets stuck in there, you can push your marker through it to get the other piece out. And we are going to adjust that metal piece on the base and adjust that metal piece inside the toothbrush. Put the negative side in. Yep, negative, that's right, because it's the flat part. That goes against the spring. Mm-hmm. Line up the arrows.
That's
second thing to do. Now work it.
Try it. Yes. Good. So sometimes you just need to twist the bass or bump the bass or even play with the switch a little bit because they're really tricky. Okay, we got it pushed through. Good job. Okay, now when we make our robot, the bottom part actually needs to be at the top. Noodlebot. What do you think?
Okay. I think I should do orange hair.
Orange hair? Okay. So we're going to cut our pipe cleaner. And when you're cutting pipe cleaner with scissors, you need to use the back of your scissors. That'll give your cut more power, so it's stronger. Good job. Okay, and if you like curly hair, like this guy right here, I'm gonna show you how to do that. You take a marker and a piece of your pipe cleaner and hold the end into place, and you're gonna wrap it around that marker. We have, it's like a spring, boing, boing. Do you wanna try it? Then I'm gonna stick that pipe cleaner into the pool noodle because this pipe cleaner has a wire in the middle of it. And it just sticks right into the pool noodle. It's really cool. Oh, you got a little tiny piece of hair. That's so cute. You guys can make any kind of hairstyle you want. You can make short hair, long hair. You could just do antennas if you want. This is your pool noodle doodle bot, so you can do whatever you want on it. So when you're done making your hair, you want to make sure you have two pieces of pipe cleaner left. They could be matching pieces or mix matching pieces. It's up to you, but these are going to make the arms. So this is one piece of pipe cleaner cut in half. And that's going to make our arms today. And you let it go, that's good. Okay, now it's time that we can put our face on our noodle doodle bot. I am going to do some eyes. And on the other side, it's, what is that, like a dog or a cat?
Yeah.
Juliet, we've got to give our doodlebot legs.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So you're going to take your rubber band and put it around your pool noodle. Okay, everybody, before we put legs on our doodlebot, I want to talk to you about markers. So you're going to put your legs on with the lid on your marker. As soon as you take your lid off your marker, if your marker's upside down on the paper, it's going to bleed, which means it's going to just keep letting out the ink of your marker and probably waste all your marker ink, okay? But if you put the lid on when you're not using it, then it won't waste all the ink. Also, we know when the lid is off our marker, what happens? It dries out. So if you're doing the Noodlebot and you're watching it, you can have the lid off. But as soon as you're done, put that lid back on so that you can use your markers later and the ink won't dry up and the ink won't all spill out onto your paper. Now I'm putting two pieces of paper down on each doodle bot. Pull this rubber band up.
I know that.
And pull this rubber band up. Good. Yep, and try it out on the paper with the lid on before you take the lid off, just to make sure it balances. You might need to adjust one of the markers or adjust the pool noodle because you want to make sure it's not like leaning to one side. Okay, Julia, are you ready to start?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna take my lids off. Now, Julia, we know because we've made one before that sometimes you have to play around with it, okay? We're gonna turn on the switch. It's going. I'm gonna play around with my legs, make sure they're all even. Put it down on the paper. And make a little bit of adjustment here and there. Make sure all my markers are nice and straight.
Yeah.
Take a little bit of playing with it.
I like to say that.
Yes. Whoa, there it goes. Sometimes they turn around.
Yeah.
But mine's going straight.
I do my face. paper.
Yeah, let's see what yours does.
Just in there.
Well, it's going away. Oh, now yours is turning circles. Mine is coming to visit you. Hello.
Hello. I'm just drawing circles.
You're just drawing circles over here. Okay, remember, if yours isn't working, just play around with it. Do all those tricks that I showed you with the battery, with the inside of the toothbrush, play around with the rubber bands, play around with the heights of the markers. This is engineering, so sometimes engineering, you have to play around with it, and you might make a few mistakes, and that's okay. Just keep trying, just keep fidgeting with it, and eventually your Noodle Doodle bot will keep going and going and drawing. Did you have fun today, Juliet?
Yeah.
Owie. Did you make a robot today?
Yeah.
That draws on paper? That's so cool. High five, Juliet. Good job today. Noodle Doodle Bot. Noodle Doodle. Have fun making your noodle poodle. Noodle Doodle. What's it called?
What is a Noodle Doodle bot?